Today we're going to be talking about Power BI Premium Gen 2. Let's go. All right, my name is Chris Wagner. At Chris BI, we've been working with Power BI Premium Gen 2 for the last 12 to 14 months, way before it was in preview. We've been dealing with this since literally day one. This is a super exciting topic. Want to let you guys know some more details and information around what is Power BI Gen 2. Why do you want to start using this as soon as you possibly can? Join the Analytics Rebel Alliance. Fight for data literacy. Like, subscribe, leave a comment down below. Turn on alerts so you don't miss any future missions. Okay, when you start thinking about Power BI Premium Gen 2, you need to think of it as a superset to analysis services. Power BI Premium continue to give you all of the great features that you know and love about Power BI when it comes to unlimited viewing of content, data flows, AI workloads, all of that good stuff. But the big thing that Gen 2 brings that we've never seen before, you know, even really with analysis services, you know, any other compute models when it comes to managing our analytical processing, is the dynamic scalability. Analysis services, though, is the heart and is the engine that drives Power BI. So it is where all of the processing is done. It's where all the computation comes from. And it's the engine that is upgraded in Gen 2 that, you know, I'm super excited about. As we think of Power BI Premium Gen 2 and we start to focus in on the analysis services portion of this, what we're really talking about is the natural evolution of how we think about analysis services. First, it started off with running this in an on-prem environment where you have your SQL Server analysis services running on a box that you manage. Then we migrate that out into the cloud and we're running that either on a VM or we're running it in Azure analysis services. Either way, it was a separate service that was pretty much the identical service that was running on-prem. Power BI Premium Gen 2 is truly that next step where we talk about evolving the way that analysis services engine is managed. When we talk about managing analysis services in either of the previous worlds, you really had to think of three different elements. You had to have room inside of memory for compressed storage of data. 70% of your memory had to be allocated for storing that compressed data. That other 30% allocated up into like half and half chunks, one for user activity. So as users interact with that data, as it becomes compressed and uncompressed, it goes in and out of that user activity cache. So it's super easy, super snappy, super fast for when the users are working with. And then you need to have a block of memory for your data refresh. 15% means you're refreshing table by table or partition by partition necessarily of your model within that 15% window. You end up having to refresh your entire model. That means that these ratios need to change entirely. If you need to do full refreshes on your model, your cap on your model size has to be whatever's available inside of available memory. So really you're talking about a 40% cap on memory if you're doing full refreshes. When you have multiple models on the same server, you run into really the same kind of constraints, right? You can have a model that's 20% of your total memory. You know, you could run three models at 20% and one at 10. And this type of configuration that I have here works really well. But what happens if any one model takes up more memory than is available for the refresh? Users will get errors around like out of memory and can't access the information. Power BI Gen 2 allows for near infinite scale out capabilities when it comes to having different models that are deployed. So gone are the days where you have 100 gigs of memory that you're really capped at that 70 gigs of memory total between all of your models. Now you can really go with like 70, 70, 70 and still be able to run, operate, and be able to do refreshes within a cap, be able to manage that independently. This is a massive step forward when it comes to managing analysis services and memory, especially if we're talking about very large models with a high degree of user interactivity where people are working. Say, okay, now this is no longer a limit. Where is the limit? Let's get into that. And this is kind of the exciting part because the limit shifts away from being memory-based to core-based. How many processors do you have at any point in time to either be doing refreshes and processing or having user interaction? So Gen 2 does not change the framework when it comes to the number of cores that you have for any size mouse. Here's the big thing that Gen 2 offers. It's that it offers truly scalable compute resources so that you can go in and you can allow for excess compute when necessary. Now it's constrained by how many processors that you have going. Hello, this radically is about to shift the way you think about how you manage your Power BI Premium instances. Because in Gen 1, Power BI Premium would always prioritize user interaction and the front user experience. In Power BI Gen 2, the prioritization comes into the back-end processing of the reports and the information that you have flowing into your system. So this is going to become very important for you as an administrator to be monitoring and managing how many things you have running inside your system. If you overload your service, you're now going to see negative front user impacts because of the scalability of the platform gained some efficiencies there. Great. Chris, what do you mean by scalable on compute? That means you as an administrator can decide how many additional processors your Power BI Premium tenant has available to it. More importantly, honestly, this is more important, where does that charge go? You may be in a situation where you as an IT team or your enterprise IT is paying for the Power BI Premium utilization. What you can do with this Power BI Premium Gen 2 is you can decide per capacity what Azure subscription gets the charge. You ask, what is the cost of this? Well, the good news is Power BI Premium Gen 1, Gen 2, the baseline costs are going to be staying the same. Every additional core that you get is $85 per core per 24 hours. Core allocation goes in 24-hour blocks. So, you know, if you need a core for a period of time, you're going to get it. You'll have that for 24 hours for processing. And then if it's no longer needed at that end of the 24 hours, it will shut off. If you had a P1 capacity and you set it up so that you had 8 cores available for overload and for scale-out capabilities, you ran that for an entire month, you would spend $20,000 on your scale-out. You should not do that, right? It's 4 times as expensive to be running these scale-out compute. So these are the situations, if you're hitting this, or you're finding this type of thing that you need, you should 100% just be going from a P1 to a P2. Now, good news. You don't have to just turn this on and allow unlimited compute to flow through there. You can set it up so you can cap how many processors that people are allowed to have or not. And then you can monitor and realize, okay, hey, we should have been upgrading this to a P2. This is a fantastic solution for you when it comes to how do you manage and operate. If you're looking to mitigate and manage your costs, because Power BI Premium Gen 2 is so powerful, you want that running in your front-end services, your production environments that users are hitting and interacting with. As you develop, it's really important that you use Power BI Premium per user licensing for your development engineers. So as you build out your models, as you build out your data flows, as you build out whatever it is that you're going to need your premium resources for, you use premium per user for that development. That'll help you manage your costs, manage your compute, and keep this really low. Creating your Power BI Premium user workspaces for your dev and QA environments, so your engineers will get premium per user. Any of your test engineers or your quality engineers, they'll get PPU licenses. And anyone on the business who's doing like sign-offs on stuff, you give them a premium per user license. But overall, you can really cap and limit the number of premium per user licenses you have. With premium per user in your lower environments, and Power BI Premium in Gen 2, this allows you to use full-on DevOps when it comes to managing all of your code, minus reports. Microsoft, get on that. Reports can't be managed in DevOps, at least not in any really reasonable ways. When it comes to your models, when it comes to your paginated reports, and models is truly the big thing that you're trying to manage here. Build and manage your model in a Git repo through your DevOps pipelines, deploy it out into your premium per user dev environment, migrate that into QA, then migrate that out into production. This is really pretty simple. You'll end up using a service account. So in my case, the Power BI Luchador is my service account. So I have a Power BI Premium per user license for my Power BI Luchador account. Don't tell him, he doesn't know. But the Power BI Luchador, his account is used for our DevOps processes. So it moves everything from dev to QA to production. And it's all done using deployment pipeline. Then when it comes to monitoring of your environments, we leverage the Power BI and log analytics integration. I have a video on that, links down below. But basically you set up a Power BI, or I'm sorry, basically you set up a log analytics workspace. You connect that to the workspace inside of Power BI, and then you can put reports on top of that for monitoring for usage, performance issues, impact. Then you could string that information out as far in the history as you want. Or dump that information into a SQL database for monitoring and tracking, whatever's going to make the most sense for you as an organization. This is a fantastic option. I have a video coming out later on how you can do this, how you can make this actually happen. Look out for that. Okay, when we talk about migration strategy, literally 99% of your SSAS and AAS models should be migrated out to Power BI Premium Gen 2 almost as soon as you can. The speed and the performance of Gen 2 is just mind-boggling. I have literally seen 500 to 1,000x increase in performance. I've seen some models that we were on SSAS that we migrated out into Gen 2, and we saw that type of increase in performance with user interactivity. Users were hitting the models, and how much faster this Gen 2 environment is. 100% you should be using this. So 99% of you can talk about doing this migration like right away. And frankly, you should be talking about doing this migration right away. Plan it out. Thank you so much. That's Power BI Premium Gen 2, the basics, the overview of it. I hope you found this useful. I'm going to be doing some videos where we actually run through some of the stuff and get into some demos in the future. Please stay tuned for that. If you like this content, like, subscribe, turn that alarm bell. Really helps me out. I appreciate it. You guys have a great day. Peace.